Hi, my name is Tom, and you are at level 27 in mastering Einstein's special relativity. This episode is all about time dilation. It's a B level, so we will be using the space-time diagram, which I explained in level 26B. Let's get into it. So this is the setup, which I introduced in level 27A, and I will shortly I'll do a short recap on what we saw. I introduced a house with a clock, and we are in the house. There is a train with its own clock, and it's moving at 80% of the speed of light. There is an observer in the house where we are as viewers as well, and he is observing the clock on the train. And there will be an observer in the train who is watching at our clock in the house with his telescope. And I showed you two animations. This was the first one. And the clock in our house traveled 60 seconds in time. And we saw, we talked about this, that the number of seconds passed on the train's clock is not 60, but it's 36. And we talked about that the number of seconds on the clock, which you see in the telescope, is even more less. It's less. It's 20 seconds. And this was the second animation. Now the train is not moving, but the house is moving from the perspective of the train. And we did the same thing. We let the clock in the train, because now we are in the train, travel for 36 seconds. And we watched the clock in the house. And the clock in the house ticked 21.6 seconds, and we saw in our telescope 12 seconds. And this was really confusing. We talked about this in the previous level, and we got this conversation. The observer to the left says, "When my clock is at 60, my intuition tells me that your clock should be at 60 as well. But Einstein tells me it will be at 36, so I decided to pick up a telescope and I saw 20. And then the other observer says, "Well, when my clock was at 36, I thought yours would be at 36 as well, but I saw 21.6. No, I didn't see 21.6. Einstein tells me it is 21.6, but I saw 12. And then I said, well, two things can happen. These two scientists can have a breakthrough and bring science to the next level, or there will be a fight, you know. They have the proof, you know, and it's not consistent. Their observations are not consistent. And this will give you a headache. And now I want to show you how this works using the space-time diagram. First, start with classic time dilation, which explains why moving clocks tick slower from the perspective of the non-moving observer. This is the space-time diagram. We have the house. We are now in the perspective of the house. And we have this train going at 80% of the speed of light. And our clock just ticks each second 1 second. And I introduced a perspective slider. I built this online as well. We will go online. You can do this for yourself. But now, for now, focus on the pictures. This is how the world looks from the perspective of the train. His clock is steadily ticking second by second from his perspective, the train's perspective. The clock is not ticking any slower. It's ticking just as it has always ticked. And the house is moving to the left with 80% of the speed of light. Now I punched in the clocks of both observers, the clock of the house and the clock of the train. And you see that the timestamps of the train, it looks like the time axis is dilated. And that's why it's called time dilation. So it's always running behind. And from the, And now, and if we switch perspective, you can just watch what happens at these times, you know. From the house perspective, the train's clock is dilated. From the train's perspective, the house's clock is dilated. You can see this by going back and forth between the two perspectives. And here you see at 60 seconds in the house, the train clock will be somewhere between 30 and 40 seconds. For real. That's the actual truth. And it's in fact 36. What did I do here? Yeah, I repeated the conversation about classic time dilation because observer number two says when my clock is at 36 in the train, your clock is at 21.6. So they are arguing back and forth. Your clock runs slower. No, your clock runs slower. So how does this look in the space-time diagram? Well, this is what's going on, you know. From the train's perspective at 36, the house is at 21.6. From the house's perspective at 60, the train is at 36. So here you can see how powerful it is to use the space-time diagram and switching perspectives back and forth. And we can actually do this online in a minute. Now let's make it real time. And this is a little bit more difficult. The house, the researcher, the scientist in the house said, I saw on my telescope that your clock was at 20 seconds. How does this work? Well, here you see the space-time diagram again. And I drew a line, a black line, at an angle of 45 degrees, because that's the speed of light. And you will see that the light from the train at 20 seconds starts traveling with the speed of light to this telescope, and it takes some time. And when the clock in the house is at 60, that light will reach the telescope. So this is the travel line for the light emitted from the train, and the light goes from that event to the telescope. So at 60, the person in the house will see the blue clock in the telescope being at 20. And not 36, although 36 is the actual truth. That's classic time dilation. 20 is real-time time dilation, or real-world time dilation. I can do this the other way around as well. So now we are in the perspective of the train, and you see when the house's clock is at 12 seconds, light starts to travel towards the telescope on the train, and it reaches the train telescope at 36. Travel line, again, 45 degrees, because that's the speed of light. So here I put in all the different events. I put in the events of the house, like 21.6 seconds and the 60 seconds, and I put in the events on the train, like 36 seconds and also his 60 seconds, and I put in those and 20 seconds, and I put in the lines of the travel lines of the light, and you can just change the perspective. So let's do this. Are you up for it? Just go on internet, type in this link, it will be in the description below as well, and join me. So I'm going to switch my view to my other window. Here it is. So here you see the website that I built for you to use. And you can go with your mouse, take the perspective slider, and you can just switch perspectives. And you can see why both observers are absolutely right. Einstein is right, but also their telescopes are right. And you know, it's not intuitive. It's not intuitive. When I say your clock runs slow, you tell me, no, your clock runs slow. We are equally right. And that's what makes special relativity difficult, tough. But by doing this, going back and forth and just playing with it and see what happens, how time stretches when you change perspective and when time dilates, you will see why this is actually the case. So this is how it's done in the space-time diagram. So let me see. I need to go to the other window. Yeah, oh, this is it. This is it. I go back to this. So if you enjoyed this, you can see much more. I made many videos. Here are the 18 first levels. You can just pause the video and see if there's something you like. And here are the second batch, and we are now at level 27B. If you just want to follow the main headlines, you can follow the green lines. But if you want to know everything, I invite you to do the intermediate levels as well. And every time I have three levels. The A level is for everyone. The B level is a little bit more difficult using the space-time diagram. And the C level will use the actual math. So if you are, well, if you are really a daredevil, then go to the next episode 27C, where we will do classic time dilation and real-world time dilation, but now using the mathematics behind it. I want to thank you for watching and hope to see you at the next level.